In this video, we're going to be talking about setting a budget for your bridesmaids. Hey Wealth Builders, it's Akiva. Welcome back to another episode of The Bemused, where we are making sense of all things money for the bewildered and confused young adult. So if you're into that, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, hit the notification bell so that you never miss a new video from us. So as you guys know, my fiance Mishak and I are getting married later this year. And so we went through the process of picking our bridal party, our lovely, lovely, lovely bridal party. And in that process, we developed a budget for our bridal party. So I'm gonna talk about specifically the budget that I came up with for my bridesmaids and why it's super important, in my opinion, to give your bridesmaids a budget. Trust me, it'll save yourself a lot of stress and heartache and tears. Being a bridesmaid can get really expensive, especially depending on your expectations as a bride and what caliber of stuff you want for your wedding. Some of the things bridesmaids have to pay for on top of the typical wedding guest expenses, like getting themselves to and from the venue and providing a gift, they gotta still buy their dress, they have to do their hair maybe a certain way, do their nails, do their makeup. They gotta throw you a bachelorette party and attend the party, and if it's out of town, that's extra expense there. They even sometimes have to throw you a bridal shower if that's something that you want or expect, and so being a bridesmaid can be really, really, really expensive. So I am a big believer in establishing a budget for your bridesmaids, and so here are a few tips based on my experience so far. The biggest thing is to set expectations up front with your girls. When I asked each of my girls to be in my wedding, I presented them with a bridesmaid's budget, saying this is how much approximately that we expect to spend, or I expect you to spend, on the dress, on your hair, on your makeup. I included the things that I'm gonna be providing versus the things you have to pay for. For example, I am providing the hotel room for the night before the wedding so that we can all stay in one spot together, and that's on me. I'm providing the bouquets, but you have to pay for X, Y, and Z. But this is the ceiling, this is the cap at which I am going to have these expenses, so we're not gonna look at dresses over X amount of dollars because that is not in the budget. It's also important to not let them feel pressured when asking them to be your bridesmaid. Don't be offended if somebody says no or they say they have to think about it for a couple of days, because honestly, it's better that they drop out now or say no from the beginning than to say yes and then realize that they don't have the funds or the resources to make it work and then cause you as the bride or as the, you know, the other members of the wedding party a lot of stress and heartache. It's not that they love you any less, you're just really trying to be practical and respectful of everybody's financial situation. Something I didn't do in the beginning, but I wish I did, one of the mistakes I made, was I gave them a budget, but I did not give them a timeline in terms of payment. So when it was time to look at dresses and I was starting to say, hey, what do you guys think about this? What do you think about that? Everybody's like, yeah, the dresses are great, they're pretty, but we don't have the money right now. So setting expectations in terms of when you need certain portions of the money is going to be also very important, and that will definitely weigh in on their decision making as well and save you a lot of stress. So having a budget and also having a payment timeline is very important. Having a realistic payment timeline that everyone can agree with and stick to. And just realize that you have to be flexible. You're not always gonna get everything you want as the bride, especially if you are choosing certain people to be in your wedding and you're at a certain stage of life. I'm 22 and I keep forgetting that that's pretty young to be getting married in the grand scheme of things. So one facet of getting married young is just knowing that naturally most of the people that you love, that you want to be in your inner circle on your wedding day standing by your side, are either gonna be in school or just starting out. They're not gonna have buttloads of money. And so I really had to manage my expectations and desires based on that fact. So for example, I told them right off the bat, I don't expect to have an out-of-state bachelorette party because I understand that might be out of reach for most people. I also don't have the expectation of having a bridal shower. If someone in my family wants to throw a bridal shower, great, but I am not expecting one. I do want to have a get-together with my girls, so whether that is a local event somewhere in New York where I'm from or somewhere that's local to most people, I'll be a-okay with a really calm, budget-friendly hangout night, because that's really all that matters, is having a good time with them and them being there to support me. And then also try to subsidize costs for your bridal party as much as you are physically and financially capable of doing. So like the examples I mentioned earlier, paying for the hotel the night before the wedding, paying for the bouquets, paying for different little things that the bridesmaids might need. If you're able to subsidize even more costs, like paying for half of their hair and makeup or something like that, do whatever you can do to also help the bridal party stay on budget and make it an enjoyable experience for everybody. For those of you guys who have been married and had bridesmaids and either did or did not have a bridesmaid's budget, I really wanna hear what your experiences were like in the comments below. Teach us young gals something. Hopefully I don't repeat any of the mistakes that you guys made and we can all learn from each other. So those are my tips for making a bridesmaid's budget based on my experience so far. Like I said, we'll see how things turn out. We still have a while to go before the wedding day. But this is just something that I feel like a lot of people don't really talk about or don't really have a lot of experience with, and so I just wanted to share my two cents. Before you go, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell if you want to see more content just like this. Of course, as we are going through this engagement period, we will have more videos about relationships and money and marriage and our wedding budget and all the things, and so if you're interested in seeing that kind of content, make sure you stick around and join the squad. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.